Clara lived with you guys, which means Morris had already died.
Sarah.
Clara.
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 Clara Zion lived with you guys. That's because Morris had already died.
Lived with us till I was about 15 years old.
When she died.
And she died of a heart attack. She was had a bad heart, had diabetes. She was a mess. She was not very old.
Yeah.
I don't think she was more than maybe 55, 60 years old. But she was in shit shape.
Yeah. What about Morris? When did he die? When and how did Morris die?
Morris died in 26. He was died after the grandma and Ruth and Albert got married. A year or so afterwards, they got married. They got married, I guess, at 26 or 27, and he died, I think, a year after they got married. I remember Mother telling me that she sat with him while he was dying.
The what?
She sat with him, Grandma Ruth Dubbin sat with Morris while he was dying.
And she was a married girl at that time.
Right.
Then, somewhere around that time, she and Albert moved. He applied for admission to the University of the hell was
Cumberland.
in
Cumberland Law School
Tennessee,
in Tennessee, right?
Lebanon.
Cumberland.
Cumberland Law School in Tennessee?
What's that?
Was that the Cumberland Law School in
The
Tennessee?
law school was
Cumberland.
still around. What did you say? Cumberland?
Cumberland?
Cumberland!
Okay.
They moved to Tennessee too. Cumberland was in Lebanon, Tennessee, which was a suburb of Nashville.
Right.
And he lived in Lebanon. She had an apartment in Nashville, got a job. It was a woman's wear company, some Jewish people. And went to work. Well, she was, turned out she became pregnant. And
With
she was
you.
with me.
Yeah.
They were, he was in school, she was working. And remember she told me they had these heavy winter coats and she had difficulty picking them up. Particularly when she was pregnant, and that she bled a little bit as a result of
She did what?
she, I could have been an abortion.
Yeah, she was spotting.
She
She
spotted.
spotted blood.
Oh.
And they took her off the heavy coat section, put her on smaller clothes.
So she was a sales clerk. Okay.
Then, you know, his course was a year and a half. He finished it, and they went to Miami, and drove back to Miami, and I was born August 1st. I'm a little unclear as to, I'm a little unclear as to where they lived and who they were with, what they did, except I know that he took the bar exam 1930. He failed. may have taken it, actually you may have taken it in 29 when I was just born. And he failed it. Took it again in 1930 and passed it. Opened up a law office. And that was about it. They lived in little tiny apartments. I remember one of them, actually the first one I remember was on First Street and near 17th Avenue, where we had on a little Northwest First Street between 16th and 17th, which was a street that we lived on for till I was 11 years old.
Yeah.
We lived in a garage apartment behind the building. It's still there.
Really?
The behind the house. And they rented. And our recollections of the apartment, I couldn't have been more than maybe three, two or three, maybe. And we lived there for a while. Interestingly enough, the house, the building, the property, the house, garage apartment, ultimately was owned by the Palace. We moved from there to a rented house about three houses down. Lovely house. We lived there for some period of time. Then I remember we moved next door to another house. At that time, the Palates were living immediately on the other side of us in a small, also rented house. And that's when I first recollect meeting Norty and Ronnie and
Barbara.
And Barbara wasn't around at that time. We lived there for maybe a year. I don't know. Mother had a miscarriage. And there was some chaos in the family. Some kind, which obviously I don't know, but apparently I was becoming a pain in the ass. So they arranged for
what
me.
What did he say?
Dad was becoming a pain in the ass.
No. So they arranged for me to have a 2-week camp with grandmother's, one of her teachers, who had a farm out the west part of the county,
yeah,
which happened to be Douglas Road and about 8th Street. And I went there.
Way out in the wilderness.
They got rid of me. Mother, apparently, I think she had become pregnant with Sandra now. For some reason, they needed a respite. And I had a great time. I lived on a farm, a big old house. They had a attic, and the attic had all sorts of wonderful things, old comic strips. So I really enjoyed it. And that was over with. And next thing I know is that Dad bought the house across the street.
Who bought the Palates?
Which was a 1627 Northwest First Street. Doesn't exist anymore.
Oh, okay.
And we lived there until I was 11. Then he bought this house in South Miami Avenue.
Yeah. The house I knew. That's the house that I know.
The what?
I knew that house.
Four.
I was a lot. But the house that you lived into your 11, that's the house that the Liptons gave Grandma and Papa, Grandma and Grandpa the loan for. That's when the Liptons gave him the loan for, you were talking about earlier.
Oh yeah, Lipton. Lipton borrowed that, loaned him the money to buy both houses.
For Dade Federal Savings and Loan, or whatever
right.
it was called. Okay.
And we lived across, when we moved across the street, the Pallets moved down the street to the house that had the garage apartment back there where we had lived.
Mm.
That's where Barbara was born. So we lived here, they lived down the street. And Ronnie and I were friends. Big problem was in those days they had